everyone, this is Mara and welcome back to our modded series Miranda. So guys, happy new year, it's 2017 and yeah, it feels kind of weird to be recording again. It has been a little while since I did any recording, like almost 2 weeks I think. Oh well, a little bit less than that. But anyway, it feels weird to be back. But here we are with all the puppies here in the basement. Hi, Crispy. Hi, Gonzalez. And we definitely need to do some more dog naming very soon. But there is something that I wanted to do in this episode. It's going to be kind of a casual episode. We have some things, some animals to name, some penguins to name, and there's also some donation things that I need to update over at the Donor Mountain. But let's start with the penguins. So in the previous episode, I'm pretty sure, the Christmas episode, the lovely Kate gave me some name suggestions for the penguins, for the little blue penguins, and I really love them. So the adult penguins are going to be named Mr. Merry. There we go. Let's see. Mrs. Mary. I hope that I spelled that right. I feel so derpy. And the baby is going to be named Joy. So thanks so much, Kate, for those names. I really, really love them. And let's name this, guys. Oh my gosh. Hi, baby. Don't go anywhere. You are so tiny. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay, so baby Joy. There we go. So adorable. And I'm not sure how long it will take actually for these guys to grow up. But anyway, for now at least, we're going to take this little guy and put him there. And let's go ahead and take these. There we go. There you go, Mrs. Mary. I love these names. That was so much fun for Kate to name these guys. So thank you so much. Here we go, a little penguin couple with the baby. I love it. And let's go ahead and put these guys here. And yeah, we definitely need to figure out what to do with all the penguins. We are going to be taming a lot more penguins and naming them as well. So we need to figure out what to do with that. And I feel like we should go ahead and do some exploration, or well, some planning very soon, especially at the snowy biome, that we can figure out what to do with the penguins. But anyway, let's see. Okay, penguins have been named. And yes, I'm still wearing my Christmas outfit because I felt like I didn't get to wear it long enough. So I'm going to wear it this week, and then we are going to come back to the reality and wear the usual blue penguin skin. But anyway, so let's go ahead, and I need to get some signs. Let's see, there we go. That is enough. We need one of those, and we need one of those. Wonderful. So let's go ahead. I already forgot how to play Minecraft. Wonderful. So let's go ahead. We have a couple of donations that we need to take care of. And the first one is a Steam game donation. And let's go ahead and put it here. And this is from my good friend Tort, who gave me a Christmas present this year. Oh well, last year. And let's see. Whoa. Tortimer the Grrr. Tort gave me, let's see, Seasons After Fall, which is a lovely platformer game that I'm playing on the channel right now. Really, really loving it. Go ahead and check that out if you haven't already. So thanks so much, Tort, for that gift. I love that game. It was so much fun. And another update that we need to do here is a new Patreon. Yay! So we have a new Patreon, which is fantastic. Let's actually go ahead and put this here. And this is Papado. So thank you so much, Papado, for becoming a... Whoops, I did this completely wrong. Let's do this right, okay? There we go. Papado. And yeah, so thank you so much for becoming my newest patron, Papado. Really, really appreciate it. And this will be... There we go. Since January 2017. So thank you so much for that. And you will be, in a little bit, you will be getting your own NPC statue when you reach the next level or the next tier, which is $10. And the NPC will be added here very soon. So very excited about that. And if you are interested in becoming a Patreon, check out the Patreon link in the video description. I am planning on doing some updates for the reward tiers. So there will be some fun new additions, some fun new rewards. That's going to be awesome. What I was planning to do, let's see. I'm a little bit all over the place today, guys. Like I said, it feels weird to be recording again. I kind of got used to the vacation mode, so to speak. So, and that includes not speaking English. So it feels kind of weird to be back. Hello, hello. Hello, babe. What are you doing? What are you doing? Hugging the wall here. Hi, Huck. Very suspicious. Okay, yeah, I was thinking that we actually need to start clearing out the Christmas decorations here. So we, I did actually add some more decorations here. Since I recorded the previous episode, I wanted to make it a little more festive. So let's actually go ahead and start taking these down. And I was thinking, whoops. Hi, Hector. I'm not doing anything that I'm not supposed to do. Don't worry. Don't worry. I know that face. What was I saying? Oh my gosh, what are you... What are you doing? What are you doing in the tree? Victor having a little bit more holiday spirit, I guess, that I was expecting. Hi, Wynn. You came to check out the situation. Yeah, it's a little bit weird. I feel like Hector is doing something silly here. He's hiding in the tree, clearly. Yes, yes. I know your tricks, sir. But anyway, yeah, let's take these presents actually out. And I was thinking that we are going to save these decorations for next year. There we go. The villagers should be okay. Famous last words, I know. But let's go ahead and... Let's see, I need to make a chest. There we go, and I need a chisel for this too. So we can actually make a little bit more festive chests as well with the chisel. And, excuse me. Oh, dang it, I needed to dye this, right? Well, I feel like I should get some yellow dye from this. Okay, there we go. There we go. Thank you, thank you. Let's dye that. And there we go. Now we have some more options. Let's go with the green one. I like that. Yep, that's good. That's good. There we go. Yeah, so we are going to be taking down the Christmas decorations here, and I feel like we're going to be storing them in my little... did I add something here? Hi, guys! Going crazy as usual. Wonderful, wonderful. We are going to be storing this in my little house. Hi, Jake. I'm not doing anything that I'm not supposed to do. Don't worry, don't worry. I will hide your things. Hello, Dave, Huck. Patsy, what are you guys doing here? I feel so suspicious of these guys. Okay, there's nothing here. All right. Fine, fine. Have it your way. And I wonder if I did leave something at the... Okay, I can run, apparently. I feel like I did leave some decorations. Oh, whoopsie doodle. Okay, there's some mobs. That's fine. That's fine. The villagers should still be safe. That's what I'm thinking. Okay, there we go. Did I add anything here? I don't think so. All right. Let's actually go ahead and sleep. I'm a little bit all over the place, but let's just make sure that the villagers are going to be okay. Alrighty. There we go. I love this village, by the way, guys. I just really love it. And oh, I did have something in mind that we need to do. I need to clear out some of these chests. It has been ages since I left those there. And I'm not really sure why it has taken me so long. Okay, that guy died. Fine, fine. Not sure why I haven't really taken those random chests out of here. I feel kind of bad. I just leave all my stuff here and the villagers have to put up with all that stuff. Hello, hello, good morning. Yeah, so let's go ahead and put these decorations here. Oh, nice. I did add it here too. No Christmas trees here. Let's see. I think I did. Yes, I did add a Christmas tree here. Awesome. Awesome. And that's it. Okay. So let's actually... You know what? We could actually add some sort of shelf here. Like some sort of... storage base, a little bit something like that. And let's see, those are planks. We could add something there. Do I have any jungle wood? Okay, let's go and see. I kind of want to add a little attic to my house so that we can actually store all the things there. Let's see, there we go. Let's take those and those just in case. We should be okay now. Some loaded baked potatoes. I really need to do some more cooking. Let's see, where do I want to put this? Oh, that's not going to work actually. Whoops. Yeah, that's not going to work. Like I wanted it to work. Oh, dang it. Maybe I need to make a little basement or something like that. Okay. I think we are not going to figure this out right now. Let's just go ahead and put this here. So I'm just going to put all the decorations here and we can use them this year or, well, later this year or next Christmas as well. So that's going to be fun. There we go. And I think we did take all the decorations out of the village. At least I don't remember that I added anything else here. Alright. But yeah, there is something I wanted to do. I actually already went ahead and added some gates here to kind of separate the marketplace area from the village. But now that I think of it, since we have light up the whole area, as you can see, there's like a million torches everywhere, I feel like we can actually take this whole thing down, because the whole reason why I wanted to have this fence here was to obviously stop the mobs from wandering in and killing my villagers. But I think we are going to be okay with that. I think the golems are going to take care of them, and like I said, the whole area is so well lit up already that I don't really think we are going to have that kind of problems with mobs right now anyway. So we can take this down and we will actually be making a pathway that goes all around to the marketplace area as well. And I think I'm going to tear this one down too. It was just to, like I said, to stop the mobs from coming here and kind of like to section off this area, make it feel a little more compact in my mind, I guess. And yeah, so I think we are good to go with this. And there's also going to be another pathway here. All right, guys, it's the next day and I have been doing some work here. So I actually spent a couple of hours yesterday, after recording the previous clip. I spent a couple of hours building here because I was really thinking that why am I just going to procrastinate with this? I can just get moving on it and continue making the market stalls here and all that. So I did some work and I'm really happy how this looks so far. I did use the same sort of well design that I have in the village already. I switched around some blocks. This used to be a cobblestone, and I feel like this works a lot better. So I think I'm going to switch the blocks around with the other well as well. Well, that's a very interesting sentence. Anyway, let's move on. I also added the NPCs here and I figured out what kind of market stalls I want to have here. So here we have a weaponsmith, a fish market, let's see, enchanted books, dog treats, and all kinds of other fun doggy things, and the butcher's shop for meat and for dog food as well. And the ice cream stall is here. I also added some more signs. I really like these fancy signs. So this is how this is looking right now. And I haven't set up any trades for the new trades people here. And I was thinking that maybe we are going to use something different than the regular villager skins for the weaponsmith. I feel like this would be a pretty nice thing, like something different. It's a very mysterious guy who will sell us all kinds of very interesting weapons. And these are some of the weapons that are available with the NPC mod. Sorry guys, I feel a little bit sniffles. I'm fighting off a cold. So there we go. Anyway, I did take few of the examples here. There's a lot more options. Let's see. There we go. Yeah, there's a lot more options here, all kinds of weapons, which is pretty cool. I'm really excited about this, but obviously we are not going to be able to have all these different kinds of weapons for sale at the same time. So I was thinking that maybe we will start with a limited selection here, and over time we can switch around. He can have some new items, and some of them will be out of sale and all that, but it's going to be definitely interesting. I was checking out some of this already. We have a baseball bat here, for example, and a hammer. I just want to show you this, guys. These are pretty interesting. And the broadsword. Yeah, so some of these are definitely very interesting. This is the baseball bat and the hammer, and yes, it's a weapon, and the sword is slightly large. It's massive. Oh my gosh. But I'm really excited. I really, for some reason, I'm just really, really fascinated by the different kind of weapons and tools in the game. So I'm excited. And there's also some really cool things. We have some war hammers, even. Definitely excited. I like that. It looks like ice. So as a penguin, I really like that. Ha ha ha. So I think I'm going to be buying some of these. And this is the mithril broadsword, apparently. It's massive. Yeah. So there we go. I just picked some of this here, obviously in creative, because we are going to use creative to set up the NPC traits so that we can set them up. And for the fish market, I think that at least for now, we are going to just have the vanilla fish here. So just a regular fish puffer and some salmon. And I do need to figure out what kind of trades I want to have. So definitely, guys, if you have suggestions for the currency, like how many gold nuggets one piece of something would be. Want to check if those are zombies? No, they are squids. Yeah, so definitely let me know. I haven't set up any of the trades here, like I said. And I really wanted to make this kind of market stall here, because since we have the Et Futurum mod, we have some enchantments here that we are only able to, at least for now, get from either trading with new villagers. I don't have any new villagers that will trade this yet, but we have some new enchantments. So we have mending, we have the Frostwalker too, and also some of the really good books that we have in the game already. So I figured that I might as well add them here. So this guy will be trading those, and definitely need some suggestions how expensive those books will be. They're not going to be cheap in any means, so that it will be fair. Hello, hello. And the dog treats, let's see, for now I'm going to be having the dog biscuits for the copious dogs here. There's also going to be all the different kind of bones for doggy talents dogs, so that we can train them more. So all of those are going to be available here. And we're also going to have different kinds of meats here. So we have all the different new meats that we have with harvest craft, like rabbit, venison, turkey. They're going to be here, and I just added a stack of each so that we can mix and match and see what we are going to do with the trades, how much they are going to cost and whatnot. So there's that. And the penguin, I did set up this, so I'm not sure if I did mention it in the previous clip or not, but anyway, we have some trades here already, and we still have more ice cream flavors to add here, but I didn't add all of them because I don't have ingredients for all of those recipes. So, for example, there's, I think, cherry ice cream and vanilla, ironically, that are not added here because I don't have those trees yet. I don't have a vanilla or cherry tree yet. So I figured that we might as well just go with this for now, and when we are able to actually make some of that ice cream ourselves, we can also add the traits here, just to make it a little bit more fair, since it only costs one fish to get some ice cream. So that's what I was thinking there. And we still have the same traits with this blacksmith right here. So there we go. I'm actually, like I said, really excited about the progress here. It was definitely high time to start doing, it was about time to start doing something with this. And I also, the well is also, I think it's even deeper than the one that's in the village. So that's fun. But it's, you know, details, little things like this that make the whole area look a lot more interesting and a lot more lively. And definitely excited to start making pathways here, add a lot more decorations, park benches, some plants and whatnot. It's going to be really, really exciting. And when the world download is going to be available for you guys in the future, you guys can also come and do some trading in this area. So that's going to be fun. But there is something that I wanted to try out. I did place a ton of torches on top of the the roofs earlier, as you can see, but I really feel like I don't want to keep those right like that. It's a little too many torches. So let's actually, can I do this? Yes, thank you, wonderful. And I need a hammer. Okay, there we go. Let's do this and this and this. Yeah, so I was thinking when I was making the well, or the roof, little roof there for the well, I was thinking that we might as well add some more height to the roofs here. So I think we are just going to take this out, and we are also going to make it so that these are slabs on top of here, or at least we will try to see how it looks, and that way we would not need to have torches here, and the mobs wouldn't be able to spawn here either. So that's the thought thought behind this little operation. So let's just see. Let's just take a look and see how this will look. Not sure if that's going to work or not, but anyway, let's see. There we go. Actually, can I make slabs out of these? No. Okay, that's fine. All right, so let's see. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is going to work. It may look a little bit weird. But anyway, let's check this out. I don't know. I mean, it doesn't look too bad. Maybe I need to do some more tweaking to it. Interesting. But yeah, it would be definitely a little bit better to not have so many torches around. And I do kind of like the idea of having a little more height for the roof. It looks a little bit better than just having it flat like that. So I don't know, maybe I will do some more testing. See what else I can do with carbon dust blocks there. But yeah, I wanted to show you guys the progress here. I actually did already end the episode, but before recording this clip, but since I managed to do a lot more progress in this area, I wanted to share this with you guys in this episode as well, rather than waiting for the next one. So we are going to end it here probably in the next episode, or in the next live stream we are going to start figuring out their traits for these guys. So that's going to be fun. We need to figure out the currency, how much each of the items or the stacks of items are going to be cost and all that. So that's going to be fun, and definitely could use some help from you guys. Any suggestions would be appreciated. But we are going to end it here. So thanks so much guys for watching. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and comment below, and I will see you next time in Miranda.